Hello everyone, welcome back to the Level Editor Tutorials for Clone Drone in the Danger Zone. I'm Josh, the Community Manager, and I am here today to tell you about sections, which is something very important if you are experiencing lots of lag. You have a very large level full of lots of different things, and it is starting to make your game lag and slow down, and the frame rate goes down, and all of those things. I am here to help you fix some of that. And obviously the level I've created in front of me here shouldn't be laggy at all, but this is just for demonstration purposes. If you have big complicated levels in arena or in adventure mode, then you are going to need to use sections. The sections button on the top bar here makes this sections pull down menu, and you can get rid of it with this up arrow, appear here. You can create a new one by pressing this plus button in the top right of the box. But before we start making one, what even is a section? Well, basically a section is a group of objects that will appear and disappear depending on when you tell them to do that. So for instance, if we want everything in this front area in front of the wall to appear as soon as the clone gets out of the elevator or up to the top of the elevator, then we can add a section so that they're all in the same group together and appear at the same time. But it's our game, theoretically, is getting really laggy. So I want to halve the amount of objects that the game is dealing with at one time. So I'm going to put all of the things at the back behind this wall in a second section so that they don't load in at the same time as this first group. So I'll do that to start off with, and you can see how it works when I start playing the game. So if we select all of the objects and tick section one on the right here, and they will start disappearing. And it might be all the way down at the bottom of these info panels on the right. So all of these things have disappeared. Where have they gone? I can't see them. You can see them by ticking this little box here next to the bin and the edit button on the sections panel. So we're going to make these disappear and then start selecting all of the things on the right here and ticking section two. All of the robots, all of the scenery, all of the traps, that's a fire trap there, all now belong to section two, which is also invisible. And we can once again make that appear and disappear by clicking this tick box. These walls and this door don't belong to any section at all, and we can add them, but we don't have to add things to a section if they don't need to be. If we press play now, none of the items in this level will appear because we haven't told them to appear with triggers or anything like that. But I want section one to appear when we start the level. I'm going to click on edit and then enable on level start, which will mean that as soon as we press play, we'll go straight in here and then we'll be able to fight the enemies and see the decorations. But what about section two? Let's say that we want section two to appear once the player has gone through this door. I'm actually going to delete this door now so that we can see it appearing and disappearing as we move through there. And you'll know how to do this if you watch the triggers tutorial. We need to grab an AI trigger area and put it where we want to activate section two. So I'm going to change the shape of this so that it fits the door much more neatly. So when the player passes through or touches this A trigger, we're going to go to edit on section two and click enable on triggers A. This means that once we touch this trigger, everything in section two appears and we can interact with it. The AI start fighting and the traps become dangerous. But if we look now, both the front and the back are all visible at the same time. which means we have our initial problem of there being too much stuff and it being very laggy. There's no actual lag because I've not put too much stuff in here, but imagine I had millions or hundreds of objects in here and the game was running slowly. So how do we turn off section one over here without turning off section two? Click edit and then click disable on triggers. When the player walks through A, the section A will disappear. Now the question is, what happens if someone goes from the back through the front? All of the stuff at the front will have disappeared. We can't use trigger A for that, but we still need it. So let's move trigger A over to this side, which is the side that it makes visible. And we need to make another trigger. We can either click and drag another AI trigger, or if you want one exactly the same size, we can do Control plus C and then Control V to create another one that will be in the same place and the same size, so we can just move it a little bit and it will fit. Now this might get a little bit confusing because of the sides that A and B are on, but we need to make B part of the same section that these are in. So we're going to click section 2 here and tick that. That means that B won't appear and it won't do anything until section 2 appears. Now we need to go into section 1, edit, and enable on triggers B so that when B is around and active and you walk into it, section 1 reappears. We also need to go into section 2 and edit and disable on triggers B so that when you walk into B, the back half disappears. Now that we have both of these, this is where B would be, but it's not working because section 2 isn't activated yet. And then we walk into section 2, everything appears, and now we can walk back and make section 1 appear and section 2 disappear. So we can do this as many times as we want with this setup. Obviously, that enemy keeps on appearing and disappearing. But that shouldn't be too much of a problem. Look, he even gets stuck in midair when we disappear him. An important note is that you need to make sure there is enough distance between A and B so that the player character can't touch both at once. Just in case you accidentally trigger both and it causes lots of things appearing and disappearing all at the same time. So make sure that they're a fair distance apart. The way we've set this up, you can see both section 1 and 2 appearing and disappearing. But if you want to create the illusion that the objects in both sections were there all along, then you can hide the transition by creating a little loading area like this, where the player can't see them just magically appear out of nowhere. And I've put some extra triggers on the outside here to make these doors open. Another easy way to do this is to use the Nobody Inside trigger. So if you select the triggers folder and scroll down to 4 from the bottom, there is the Nobody Inside trigger, which you can use to cover an entire area. So if you put it inside the section that it is attached to, if there's nobody inside section 2, then you can use it to disable section 2. The only thing to note about this is that enemies count for this trigger too, so you have to make sure there are no enemies and no player inside of this area for it to work properly. But it's an alternative if you're interested in doing it that way. So that shows you the very basics of how to use sections. They have more advanced features that we might talk about in a future video, but let me know in the comments if there's anything else you'd like to know. Thank you for watching, and happy level editing!